Here we go, round one of this eight man. We're on the play. And so I assume we have to keep these kind of hands. I wish I had an early play, but there's technically only eight. Like, Simmons crying doesn't really count as a turn to play. So we're left with Jaddy offshoot and Hangerback Walker, which are both like only situationally good. So this hand's gonna be great against the mid-range decks we're expecting to play when playing this deck. So I'm gonna keep this hand. And we'll lead a forest, pass. And we're playing against mountains, so that's a really bad news. All right, we'll see what this deck can actually, oh, well, we top deck Jaddy offshoot, so that's great. So yeah, the sideboard has Seismic Rupture, which is kind of weird since there's only one mountain in the deck and they don't play any fetches. I mean, the only way to cast it turn three is with Sylvan's Crying technically and fetch the mountain. So I'm not sure if it's going to be enough, but we'll find out, I guess. Misses Pilgrimage, doesn't even get it. Explosive Vegetation gets the forest, gets the mountain, but it's like, it comes down probably way too late. And he's cried a card on bottom. And we drain out your offshoot. Still think we want to play Nissa's Pilgrimage. So that next turn we can cast offshoot and an explosive vegetation. So we'll put forest in play. One in our hand. Pass. Is fetch and has Orling Outburst, which is that's probably something we want to see just because it's one of the slowest card he has in his deck. Down to 18. We'll play offshoot and explosive veggie. The Blighted Woodland is basically two life at this point. We'll get Mountain. Gain some life. Pass. Alright, we'll block Swift Spear. Don't really mind if he Wild Slashes it or anything, something like that. Just gonna Teemer Battle Rage maybe. Okay, I guess I didn't think of a Tarkus Command, I should have. And strength. Sure. Puts a card on top. We're down to 9. Down to 9, and now he has likely 3 spells in hand. He didn't play land last turn. So play Hedron Archive and hope to like probably play Hedron Archive. Crack it, hope to draw a Ugin next turn and play Ugin or Tarka, I guess. Or I guess I can play Explosive Vegetation now and then next turn I can crack Eden Archive. Yeah, that seems a little bit better. Two lands and pass. I think it's just very likely that we die on that turn. It's kind of insane that even if we drew the 2 Jaddy offshoot, we died. And it's like not even close. It's Ring for Abbot, reveal a Tarkus command, and it has a land, so we're dead. Yep. Alright, let's go game two. This matchup is indeed quite horrible. And it's also, his job is also, I assume, hard to beat. So Fogs and Winds of Colossisma. Probably a Ruined Processor. Okay, and we board out. Okay, that's the real question. Anger backs are probably nice. We probably don't want that many Ugins. Same for Ulamog. So we have one of those Ruined Processor. Hedron Archive, probably unnecessary as well. We will definitely want these. As for lands, could probably side out a few. Like Haven. Haven's probably unnecessary. And the two Fogs. Let's say we board out another Ulamog and a Map the Wastes or Nissus Pilgrimage. Because Explosive Vegetation is probably one of the best ramps, especially with Jaddy Offshoot. So, although Map the Wastes kind of nice with Hangerback, let's try to board out one Nissus Pilgrimage. Maybe Sylvan's Crying is too slow, but there's not much we're doing in turn 2, so probably necessary. Okay, I'll keep this. Let's go to Tarko, which is one of the best cards against him, and we've got the Jaddy Offshoot. Can't really hope for better. I guess we could have Seismic Rupture. Swift Spear, sounds good. Hanger back is a really good draw. Pass. Has another Swift Spear. Wall block one. And he has Titan's Strength for it. Sounds good. Put a card on top. So here I have the choice of either Nissus Pilgrimage or pump my Hanger back. I think I'll play Nissus Pilgrimage because it ensures me that I'll be able to cast a Tarka on turn 5. But I could do the other line of pumping Hanger back, but then I would absolutely need to draw land. Which are not the worst HUDs, but this line also makes me able to pump Hanger back and play Explosive Vegetation next turn, so it's not bad. Dragon Fodder sounds good. And a Lightning Berserker. That's some amount of damage. Shrine. So I'm not even sure what that does. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, Explosive Veggie. And we'll pass. Hopefully we don't die. No Atarka's command, please. Berserker again. Alright, so if I block Berserker and Yatarka's command, I take 3, 9, plus 4, I go to 1. So if I block Swift Spear, it's probably better to block Swift Spear, I guess. Yeah, probably better to block Swift Spear. I'm gonna have some Thopters anyway, and those will be able to take care of the Lightning Berserker later. And if he does pump Lightning Berserker that turn, then I'm super happy because I just destroy his board next turn and have Tarka while not taking infinite from Tarka's command. And he's doing it. It's gonna be rough. Oh, whoa. What happened? Oh my god, I think I F6'd. So, well, it's not too bad. The only bad result from it is that I'm not getting 2 Thopters. I should be getting 2 instead of 1. Hopefully it doesn't cost us. We'll likely just die to another burn spell, but. I could Seismic Rupture or Dragonlord Tarka. Obviously, I'm just going to Dragonlord Tarka. I want to get some pressure as fast as possible. So, this. 2-2-1. Okay. So here I could attack. It's likely not going to change the clock, so I'm going to keep 2 blockers since he has Lightning Berserker in his hand. Now I can F6. Chandra. Well, that's fine. We can kill that. Okay, so I can map the waste, bolster my Thopter, and Seismic Rupture. So if I attack for 9, I map the waste, then I keep the Thopter up for his Lightning Berserker. Yeah, I have to do that no matter what, basically. Go. Siding Chandra against me, or still having it as deck, seems a little bit weak. It's incredibly slow. It's good against like slow decks without removal, like the green mid-range decks. I guess my deck is slow, but like once it's on, it's just like it doesn't care about something like Chandra. You won't have much time for it. So 8 down to 11. Yeah. I mean, I want to attack with this Thopter so that I can kill him next turn, but I have to block this Lightning Berserker, so. Maybe I draw another Map the Waste and he doesn't kill my Thopter. Drawing Ugin does it. Dragon Father. It's also somewhat annoying. Means we can't attack. Come on, a spell. Oh, Jade of Shoot's nice. Now I can attack. I might die to Titan Strength, but I don't think I can give him much draw steps. If he draws like another Tarkus command, we're just dead. Like, not attacking with Tatarka there is just, like, way too safe. No reason to do that. If he has it, he has it. But it can't just sit there infinite time. And I assume we're just dead here. I still think it's the right play to not to attack with the Tatarka. He has big armaments. So yeah, Titan Strength and big armaments, I guess, were both outs for him. Yeah, considering there's like six pumps in his deck, and I gained a life with Jetty Offshoot. Because if I don't attack, then he draws like a Dragon Fodder or Hordling Outburst or just like other creatures. I'm just like in a really bad spot. Basically, by giving him extra draw steps, like maybe an extra, at least an extra one draw step, like basically anything that's not a land will be really bad for us. So, yeah, I think it was the right play to not do to attack with the Tatarka, unfortunately. And it still, we weren't in the best spot because we still lose to a bunch of cards, but I guess that's why the matchup is so bad. Alright, so I'll be joining a two individual two-mans to finish, to show you at least three rounds of the deck.